Dear poultry industry friends, welcome to our first episode of Tune In with the Experts. In this episode, Christophe Cazaban will be interviewed about how Gumboro vaccine works. So stay tuned with the experts to know all about the benefits of controlling Gumboro disease. Enjoy! Good morning, poultry industry colleagues. We are going to talk today and discuss a little bit with Christophe Cazaban, our poultry scientific director. How are you today?
Fine. How are you, Marco?
Good. So, we are going to discuss about Gumboro vaccines. And to start, we know that in the market, we have several different vaccines, since vaccines used on the farm, applied directly on the drinking water. And we have vaccines applied as well in the hatcheries with different technologies. Okay. First, can you explain us the difference between the vaccines?
Sure. So indeed, you've got on the market different types of technologies. I will perhaps not talk about the killed vaccines, which are usually restricted to breeders before the onset of production. Let's focus on the live vaccines. And historically, we used to have conventional live vaccines that are used in the farm by drinking water application. These live vaccines are experiencing a couple of shortcomings, since, as I mentioned before, they need to be applied by drinking water, which means that the water quality is of critical importance, of course. The technicity of the people who are administering the vaccine is also of utmost importance. And last but not least, the timing of vaccine application is also critical. So as a result, there was a need to think differently. And that's why we've got on the market for some years now, the presence of vaccines that are applied right in the hatchery, either by innova routes, or so at transfer, or at hatch by subcutaneous routes. So it's much easier to be applied because it's in the hatchery with a restricted staff and high quality equipment to ensure a consistent application. On the other hand, we still face the presence of maternally derived antibodies. So that's why there was a need to find some new technologies to be able to bypass these maternally derived antibodies. And there are basically two main technologies to do so. The Marek technology, using the HVT virus as a vector of a specific gene of Gumboro virus, or the immune complex technology.
Okay, Christophe. And as is known, Ceva works and strongly believe in the immune complex, as you explained some reasons before to us. Can you explain us in a nutshell how the immune complex works? How what happens when it's applied in the chick?
All right. So you have to understand that an immune complex actually is made of a smart mixture, smart combination of a live vaccine virus and specific antibodies that are bound to it. And this mixture is injected into chickens or chicks or embryos. Right after application, there will be a slow, I would say a progressive release of the virus from the antibodies. And this is where I would say the recipe plays a role, since this release of antibodies will occur in the same time together with the decay of maternally derived antibodies that are present in that specific chick. So to summarize, if we are dealing with a chick or a batch of chicks with a quite high level of maternal antibodies at hatch, these antibodies will induce the vaccine to wait a little bit until it's able to be totally released. On the opposite, if we are dealing with a batch of chicks with rather medium to low amount of residual antibodies, then the virus will be released earlier, so the immunization process will occur earlier.
So is it important to have the live Gumboro virus on it in the vaccine?
Yes, it's very important to keep this asset of getting a full, a whole life vaccine virus into the vaccine combination as an immune complex. Since upon release, this vaccine strain will be able to quickly reach the bursa, its target organ, to replicate there. And thanks to a kind of competitive exclusion mechanism, be able to block this bursa against infection by any type of field strain.
Christophe, can we go a little bit deeper in this interaction between the vaccine strain and the maternal antibodies, the MDA?
Okay, so upon administration, the virus and antibodies will be located basically in some specific cells that are antigen-presenting cells near to the spleen and to the bursa farbicius. And from that standpoint, these cells are called follicular dendritic cells. And from that place, there will be a progressive release of the antibodies of the complex. As long as there is still a high amount of antibodies in the circulating bloodstream of this chick, there will be a constant association and dissociation cycle, if I may, of the immune complex. And once the amount of residual antibodies is getting lower and lower, as it happens anyway during the grow out of a chick, during its first weeks of life, then there will be less and less immune complex formation. In other words, there will be more and more free virus to escape from these cells and to reach the bursa. So you've got a really smart adjustment of the pace of release of the vaccine virus from the immune complex according to the amount of maternal antibodies of that specific chick. So that's why immune complex technology is particularly suitable to any kind of situation. I mean, chicks derived from young breeders, so with theoretically a high amount of maternally derived antibodies, or to the opposite, chicks from older breeders having less maternally derived antibodies transfer, or even to chicks derived from different parent stock flocks, so that they will be provided with very heterogeneous levels of maternally derived antibodies. So you've got a kind of custom-made adjustment of this release of the vaccine according to the initial status in maternally derived antibodies.
Okay, so we can understand that even if the maternal antibody is extremely important for the first protection, the immune complex vaccines can adapt to the level of the different levels according to the chick, and this way protect all the flock, right?
Absolutely, absolutely.
Okay. So, going more a little bit on the field and understanding what we have available to use, Ceva has two products. One that's TransMoon to be used on broilers and broiler breeders, and you have NovaMoon to be used on layers and slow-growing birds, right? Can you explain us why have these two products?
You have to understand that, in fact, we are talking about two completely different birds. You've got the so-called fast-growing birds, basically the meat-type birds, so the commercial broilers, broiler breeders, and these type of chickens are experiencing a quite fast metabolization of maternally derived antibodies. So that's why TransMune was specifically developed to be adjusted to this type of chicken, so broilers and broiler breeders. The so-called slow growth broilers or egg type birds, namely commercial layers and layer breeders, are experiencing a much slower decrease of maternally derived antibodies, and they are also genetically much more susceptible to the disease and to the inflammation process that is generated by the disease. As a result, it's easily understandable that we had to develop a second, very specific immune complex product that is adapted to this type of chickens. So with a different formulation of human complex, and also with a different virus strain, which is more adapted to these slow growth chickens. So that's why we've got these two different products to be used in two different types of chickens.
So, and of course, in the poultry house, there is a virus population in the litter, and the birds are in contact with it. If the bird is vaccinated with an immune complex, and these birds are going to be protected against this virus population or going to be infected by it?
That's one of the critical questions indeed. We have to keep in mind first that Gumboro virus is an extremely resistant virus. It's extremely difficult to be killed by the detergents and the disinfectants, and ultimately it's nearly impossible to eradicate Gumboro disease and to kill totally this Gumboro disease virus. So the virus will be present in the farm anyway, regardless your biosecurity, your cleaning and disinfection efforts that are still needed, of course, but you will still have some presence of virus in the field. So there will be a kind of race, a kind of competition, if I may, between the field virus and the vaccine virus to be the first one to infect the chicken. So that's why it's of paramount importance to remind and to stress the need for a careful biosecurity, cleaning and disinfection procedures in the farm. Secondly, to keep maternal immunity present thanks to a proper vaccination of the breeders, because we do need this very, very early protection in the first weeks of life. And then by applying transmune in broilers or novamune in layers to enable the birds to be protected as early as possible according to this disappearance kinetics of the maternally derived antibodies.
And to close, how does it impact the broiler's health?
Do you mean the presence of the virus or the vaccination?
All the process of be infected or not infected and be protected or not protected.
All right. So again, keep in mind that Gumboro virus is a strongly immunosuppressive virus. So any type of field infection, even though it may be regarded as mild or subclinical, it will damage your performances because this virus is intrinsically capable to damage your the immune status of your birds. So it means they are going to be more likely to get some secondary opportunistic infections. We can think about E. coli, which in turn will decrease your slaughterhouse performances because of increased air circulitis, for instance. So that's why it's critical to succeed in the vaccination process flock after flock in order to protect your performances, and even though after a while to step by step improve your performances thanks to this proper control of this very critical disease.
So with that, we close this episode. Thank you very much, Christophe,
Thank you, Marco, for this
really useful information.
Thank you. Keep well.
Thank you for watching this episode. And do not hesitate to give us your feedback by commenting down below in the comment section. Goodbye, stay safe.